Hi there everyone, welcome back to the vlog. Everyone, I'm talking about everyone actually requested this video, so I'm gonna give you guys this video. So, just get the wheels quick and get it fitted on the toy. Most of you guys are most probably wondering why is there a set of black Velocity rims on the Conquest, and I'm going to explain to you guys why I have a set of Velocity wheels on this car. So the story behind the story is that a friend of mine actually bought himself the exact same car, and on that car he had a set of 15 inch Rotiforms with 1 and 5 50 15 inch tires on, and the Tonkin wheels I currently had at the time needed a refurbish, as well as needed two new tires. I could replace all four tires because the front tires weren't as good as well. He made me offer and said we can do a straight swap. Obviously his wheels also needed two tires and also needed a refurbish, so I was keen for the swap. And I took the wheels, I put the wheels on the car. I leave a photo of the car on the screen now with the wheels. I posted it on Instagram and asked you guys like the wheel on the car. Like 20% of the people actually said yes and the other 80% said no. So what I did was, I took the wheels off the car, took it down to my neighbor, and we actually agreed on doing a swap because he owned these Velocity rims. He actually bought these wheels by me a couple of months ago because I bought it at a friend of mine, Alan, and that's how we actually swapped the wheels, and now we left with this set. But this set also needs a refurbish, as well as need two tires at the back. Luckily I actually have one tire, so I only be needing one more tire for the driver side rear rim. But at the current moment, many of the guys actually requested me to fit the City Sports on this car. And because I am going to refurbish this wheels, I'm going to start prepping them on my next video. I was actually thinking, why not do a video of revealing this wheels on the Conquest, because many of you guys actually like to see that look. And a lot of people have been asking me, where do you get a set like this? Unfortunately guys, the only way you can get it, if you go to Volkswagen, the dealership itself, you can buy one rim. I'm talking about one rim for 5,500 rand. If you're lucky, you can pay that price for a set secondhand, but to get the set secondhand is very, very scarce. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. Me, myself, I also paid, like I actually overpaid for these wheels, and I still needed to buy tires, and you guys can see the wheels are still badly curbless. That is what you guys have to settle for out there if you guys really want these wheels. But unfortunately, like I said, you don't usually get it very, very common on the secondhand Facebook post. So guys, let's get straight into this video. What I will be doing, I'll be checking out the car, taking that wheels off, and we can actually do a slight comparison between the 1 5 50 15 inch tires as well as the 1 6 5 45 15 inch tires, because many of you guys actually wanted a comparison between this profile and the profile currently on the car, because many of you guys want to go from this profile right here to that profile, and you guys want to know the pros and cons. So I might just mention a few pros and cons as well, but let's get this wheels off the car. front of me right here we have this sport wheel with the 165 45 15 inch tire on, and we have the velocity wheel with the 195 50 15 inch tire on as well. This is the comparison between the two rims. So the velocity rim looks like this, city sport wheel looks like this. Not a very big difference, but I obviously prefer this one above this one because you don't get tired of this one, you don't get tired of this one, but that one is just more unique. Anyways, let's get to the tire. You guys can see this one's profile is actually way thicker than this one's profile. I'm not sure how tire manufacturers like work this out, because if you check this, this is a 50 and this is a 45. So I think it's like the profile of the tire, don't get me wrong, the profile of the tire is 50% of the worth of the tire. And obviously you guys can see the worth of the tire, it can't be 50% because 50% is around there, and it's actually way thicker. So I'm not sure how they work out like the entire size of the tire and stuff like that, but this is just a simple comparison between the 165 45 15 inch, which is for stance, and obviously the original tire that these wheels came out with is the 195 50 15 inch tire. I wouldn't recommend using this 165 45 for daily use, and trust me guys, the 40 profile is actually way worse than the 45. The 45 drives comfortable, everything is nice about it, but as soon as you go a little bit wider with the wheel, I think these wheels are from factory 6.5J, so that's why I always prefer fitting these tires on a normal 6.5J or 7J wheel, because it's actually perfect. But as soon as you go wider, which is like 7.5 or 8J, even 8.5, then the risk actually gets way way higher of getting a tire burst. And obviously this one came out of factory for reliability, this tire, or this profile tire, which I would recommend above this one if you're actually using your car daily. But obviously for stance purposes and you guys want to go lower, obviously the thinner profile will always be a very very good win. But at this current time, from my perspective, I use a 175 50 15 inch tire for daily, which I actually use on the caddy. But unfortunately the caddy is not here. As you guys can see, we have the Honda here and the GTI in that garage, but the caddy my daddy took to work today. I will do a tire comparison of the 175 50 15 inch tire with these two tires in the future, and we can actually have a nice video regarding that. But let's get the wheels on the car. So I will be fitting the city sports on the car. Just keep in mind I won't be dailying the car. The only reason I'm fitting the wheels on the car at the moment, because I don't have a set of wheels for this car. This wheels is initially actually for the other thing, but if I do get a buy for it, I might just let it go, because I kinda need the cash, so I might just resell it again. But guys, most of you guys have requested me to actually slam this car, and unfortunately I can't slam the car because this car has springs and struts in. I know you guys turn down the spring and stuff like that, but unfortunately that reduces the lifespan of your shocks, and I literally don't feel like that. And many of you guys always ask me, do I have coilies in the car? And as you guys can see right here, no, I actually don't have coilies in the car. I actually cut the springs in front, two rings off or two rotations off, and at the back I cut off 1.5. Great fitment though. But there's gonna be a little bit more of a wheel gap on this wheel because of the tire. But let's get you guys on the tripod real quick, and let's start fitting these wheels on the car. Actually like this wheel on this car, no lies, it looks simply amazing in the car. And obviously with the chrome studs, it makes the wheel pop a lot. I think I might just keep the wheel in the car for some time, but I'm gonna pop the car on the road real quick and give you guys a comparison of the profile tires, the 155 50 15 inch on that side and the 165 45 15 inch on this side. guys can see right here, here we have the City Sports undercar with the 165 45 15 inch tires, and the mud flap is like on the ground. I'm talking about like a finger from the ground, which is actually very, very dope and very, very low, to be honest. And I think this is a very, very nice ride height, to be honest, especially for daily use. I'm actually very, very like interested to know how the car will drive, but this is the 1 and 550 15 inch tires on. And obviously you guys can see right here, here we have like, okay, can't focus, but here we have like a finger above the tire. At the back we also have like, well, a finger, and this is how it looks this side. But if you check this side and compare like the gap, which is like, yo, it's like three fingers this side at the back, and obviously I think it will be like two fingers here. Yeah, like two fingers. But guys, I'll definitely recommend this wheel for this car. Damn guys, it looks super amazing. But let's get the car reversed in and let's start off with the passenger side real quick. Can't help but love these wheels on this car. Like seriously guys, like it just simply looks amazing. Obviously this side is a little bit higher than that side for some reason, although the springs are cut over the exact same amount, but obviously because of engine weight and this and this and that, the side will obviously be higher. But as soon as you drive a car, the car is actually equal, and you guys can see here, well, it's a little bit more than a finger from the ground. But these mud flaps won't last long on this car if I had to continue driving on this current height. I'm just gonna tighten up the wheels real quick, and then I'm gonna give the car a nice wash, and from there we can actually get a nice cinematics of this car as well. Guys, to be honest, like I said, for stance purposes, 165, 45, 15 inch tires are obviously the go-to if you wanna go stance. And check this out right here. I'm talking about a Volkswagen wheel on a Toyota. You can't tell me it doesn't look beautiful, to be honest. Come on guys. But let's get this wheel tightened up, then we can actually start washing this beauty. When you feel it's hopeless, when you think that you lost, oh, I will take your hand and we'll rise up from the dust. I just finished off with the conquest. I got the wheels on the car, the car is clean. Unfortunately I didn't vacuum the car, so I definitely still need to vacuum the car, but I'll do that some other time. At the current moment I'm completely exhausted for some reason, but Now that we actually have the velocity wheels off, we can actually start planning the next video, because I actually want to get these wheels displayed black or silver. So comment down below what color you guys would like to see these wheels, because I actually bought silver and I bought black. So I have the black Glue Devil, and I obviously bought the silver of this one, and I bought a clear coat just in case. So comment down below what color you guys would like to see the Velo wheels. I know many of you guys are going to go with the original color, which is silver. So I think I might go with that color as well. But comment down below what color you guys would like to see the wheels, and we can actually respray the wheels. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe, and to click the notification bell to get notified whenever Lytic Customs is uploading new content. But guys, that will be the end of today's video. That's all I have in store for you guys. I hope you guys like the look. Which wheel you guys prefer? This current wheel on the car, which is the City Sport, or the Twin Cam wheel, or the Velocity wheel? Comment down below. But guys, stop racing and go Stones.